played beautiful the first 12 holes. Had it 4-under for the day. Front bunker on number 4, my 13th hole, the par 5, and knifed the trap shot and 3-whacked it. And kind of felt a little shooken up after that coming in. I didn't play very well the last 5 holes. I mean, birdied the 5th up the hill, knifed another trap shot on 6. You know, so it was a little shaky coming in, but, you know, not going to take anything away from the fact that I played pretty well for the first 30 holes of the first 2 days. Drove it well. Iron play was way sharper this morning. And I feel good on these greens. I mean, these greens can make you feel very uncomfortable because they're very slopey. And you feel like every putt you look at has at least a cup of break on it. You know, you're aiming. It's very hard to aim it outside the hole from 3 feet, but this is kind of what you have to do in this golf course. And, you know, my putter remains sort of one of the strengths of my game, and I'm going to have to keep it pretty hot this weekend. I mean, the way the scoring looks, you know, Brunt shooting 9 this morning, you know, at 8-under par, I'm probably going to need another 8 to have a chance to win.
Going at the end, were you looking at the leaderboard or what's going on with Brent Snedeker?
Yeah, they were right behind us, and I knew he was going low. And, I mean, you know, it's like, it's weird. You know, you get in a lead on Friday, and you start to feel a tiny bit nervous, and then you say to yourself, well, why are you nervous? I mean, you've got more than 36 holes left here, you know. So, you know, there's no point leading on Friday. You want to lead on Sundays, simple as. But to lead on Sundays, you got to position yourself well, and that's what you do the first couple of rounds and going into Saturday. So I position myself well. That's all I've done. I've got a lot of work to do. Like I say, I'm probably going to need between 8 and 10 under par this weekend to have a chance to win this great championship.
And you've been working exceptionally hard over the last couple of years to get your game to where it is now. How satisfying is it to see the results shining through?
Yeah, it's nice. I mean, you know, I haven't missed a cut in the PGA Tour since, I think, Hartford last year. So it's been a really good streak of golf for me, but it was a frustrating streak at the same time because, yes, I was playing okay, but I wasn't making any impact on leaderboards, you know. And that's when the small percentiles come in out here, you know, when you're looking at stats, you know, it's just a half a shot here and a half a shot there. And that's really all that separates, you know, 30th in the FedEx from 100th in the FedEx. It's not the set, you know, it's not the big golf that you think it is. It really is a 2 shots over 18 holes, over 72 holes. That's all it really is. So it's just putting a little better. It's just been a little better off the tee. And you know, I think the big key this year has just been putting that a little bit better. You know, I'm back to putting more like myself again, the way I know I can putt. You know, I think I'm top 10 in strokes gained on, you know, putting this year. And that's not including probably my best putting round of my putting tournament of the year, which is Dominican, because they don't even count the stats, you know. So I feel like I'm happy the way I'm trending right now. And I've got a lot of golf ahead of me, so I'm excited.
Obviously, Punta Cana is way different than here, but with respect to your game, are you carrying anything from that week into this week insofar as why you're having success through 36?
Yeah, I think there's some similarities in this golf course. I think the speed of the greens. I think some of the guys feel a little bit, you know, not very comfortable on greens this slow. Not only are they slowish, I mean, let's be honest, you can't get these greens too quick because they'd be kind of silly. So they're at a pace where we're a little unused to it. But the slope on these greens, when you get an uphill putt, I mean, you have to hit it uncomfortably hard. I think growing up on slowish greens, I adapt well to slower greens. Dominican, when I won there, the greens were fairly slow. They were a nice, what I call nice make pace. And these are the same way. You know, you when you get a look, you feel like you can have an aggressive little roll at it. And I think that's probably one of the similarities. And, you know, I'm driving it. It's probably the best I've driven it the last 2 days, probably since Dominican.
And how do you mentally stay in the present versus looking ahead to Port Rush?
I mean, I feel like I've had 3 or 4 months of wrestling with the Port Rush dilemma. You know, I feel like I've been thinking of just putting a statement out on Twitter and just saying, you know, that I appreciate everyone's concern and the people that think I should get an invite and the people that think I shouldn't get one. And, you know, I hear them. But I've pretty much come to the terms with the fact that if I play well between now and Port Rush, I will play. And if I don't play well between now and Port Rush, I won't play, and I'll deserve not to play. So I'm okay with that. The RNA don't have a precedent where they've invited guys before, and that's fine. So at least I know my fate. I'm going out here trying to win the RBC Canadian Open this weekend. I could care less about Port Rush. I mean, I'd rather win this weekend and not play Port Rush. That's the bottom line, because, yes, Port Rush will be a special week, but it's not it's not instant success. I could be there and miss a cut and think, well, what was all the fuss about? You know what I mean? It's like, I'd rather play well this weekend and let Paul Rush take care of itself. You know, I really don't care.
Graeme, how many times would you estimate you've played Paul Rush, and have you played it since the changes were
made? I probably only played it twice since the changes were made. But I mean, you know, obviously the original 16 holes, I've played them probably 500 times, 300 to 500 times. So I know my way around reasonably well. But there's no doubt there has been a few little changes and nuances and new bunkers and stuff like that. But listen, it'll be fun to be there, but it really isn't the end of the world if I'm not there. I mean, it'll feel like it briefly, but the great thing about this game, you know, you've always got a great event the next week.
All right, thanks, Graeme.
Thanks, guys.